Hi guys, a very good morning to all of you, and I'm again here to teach you SST Standard 2 Chapter 5, and the Chapter 5 name is Types of Houses. So in this chapter, in previous classes, I taught you about that why house is important and how many different types of houses are there. So just take a short look at what the previous in previous video I have taught you. So house is what? House is very important in life to what? It keeps us safe and protect us from the all kinds of dangers. In fact, it keeps us warm during the winter and it keeps us cool during the summer. So house, in fact, it also gives us shelter. So when it rains or snow. So different kinds of houses are like that. There are different types of houses. Two types of houses are there, pakka house and kaccha house. So what is pakka house and kaccha house? Now I am going to explain you. Please listen carefully. When this school will open, I will ask you the question and you have to tell me all the answer. So let's start. Like pakka house is what? A pakka house is a strong house made of stone, bricks, cements and steels, and it can be for a long time. That type of house are called pakka house. Pakka house is a strong house which is made of cements, steels, bricks, and the fourth is cement, and it can be for a long time. So that are called pakka house. Now what is kaccha house? Next, kaccha house is what? Mostly you will see the kaccha house on villages areas, and it is made of mud, straw and wood. It is usually made with mud, straw and wood, and it cannot be a strong house, and these are not a very strong house. Now in fact, people lives in the plains areas, like plain areas, they usually lived in the house like huts, bungalows, apartment, then buildings, apartment buildings, duplex houses and skyscrapers. Skyscrapers usually we can found on big cities like the Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata, then Dubai, so in these different cities we can see the skyscrapers. Now the people lived in the mountains. They have a different types of houses. Which type of houses? Different types, because they lived with the houses with sloping roofs, like that. Sloping roofs. The roofs like this, sloping. So when the rains or the snow will there, they can easily fall down on land. They can easily fall down land. In page number 27, it's written, people live in the mountains, have houses with sloping roofs, with like that, sloping roofs. You can see picture is also given, so that rain and snow slides off easily. So that the rain is very fine, or snow, it will slide easily. These roofs are mainly made of tiles and woods. So these two roofs is mainly made of tiles and wood. Is usually made of tiles and woods. Next, what kind of houses do people make in regions where it rains a lot? So here is questions. One question is there, that what kind of houses do people make in regions, in any regions where lots of rains are there? So what type of house they have to make, the people on that area, they have to make? Usually they have to make the sloping roofs. So when, because rain, lots of rains are there, so when rain falls, they directly falls down easily on the land. Next is, people living in areas where it rains a lot have houses built on stakes or poles. So these are called stilt houses. You can see here one picture is there, how the bamboos is there, and then they have made a house. So if the lots of rains are there, they can build a house on sticks or poles. So that house are called stilt houses. Stilt houses. So where the lots of rains are there, where that area lots of rains are there, People are used to build house on sticks and poles, and that house are called stilt house. Next is, people living in the icy cold Arctic regions where too much ice are there, built their houses from blocks of ice. So on that area, they use the blocks of ice to make the buildings. And these are called igloos. That house are called igloos. You can see here, this is called igloos. So where the icy areas, Arctic regions, the people use blocks of ice to make house, and that house are called igloo house. Next, people in Kashmir lived in a special house called house boat, where the boats is there, but inside the boat house are there. So that house are called boat house. They float on the water because it's a boat house. That's why they float on the water. Where the people lived in Kashmir, they especially used this type of houses. That house are called house boat. That type of house are called house boat. They float on water. You can see picture is here. Here is boat and house is there inside. So that house are called boat house. Next page number 28. Now, people who move from place to place are called nomads. So that people who moved from one place to another, that people are called nomads. So if nomads are there, then where they live? Because they can't take their house from one place to another. So how they live? And they don't have the house, they don't have that thing so that they can carry the cement, bricks, or if huts is there, then kacha house is also there, then they can carry the woods and these all. So on that time, how they lived and which house they lived, that we will see in this topic. So if the people who move from one place to another, that people are called nomads. So nomads lived in temporary houses. Means their house is not permanent. Their house is temporary, only for 2 days or 1 days. So that is called temporary house, such as tents and caravans. See the picture, tents and caravans. Tents are made of cloth and are also used while camping. So while we are going for camping in school groups, so that on that time also we used to use that house like tents. So here is also the nomads, they don't have temporary house because their work was to move from one place to another. So usually they use the tents and caravans so that again they will move from that again place, new place, and again they use the tents and caravans. So tents are what? It is usually made with cloths, and we can use the tent also while we are going for camping. You will see on the TVs and maybe something cartoon characters that with the help of tent, and then one wood is there, then that rope, with the help of rope we can just handing our tents. Next, thus we see that people build different types of houses. So thus we can see that in all chapters, in all houses, there are different types of houses. So what people just build different types of houses depending on the areas and depending the kind of place where they lived in. So the types of houses, it decided the people where they lived and what the kinds of places they are going to live. So upon that depends they just built their house. So house is also made depending to the places where they live. So we can see in this chapter different types of houses are there, like duplex, kacha house, pakka house, then hut and apartment building, then stilt building where the tumas rain is there, then we can use to build stilt building house with the help of sticks or poles. In fact, an igloo also where too much ice is there, ice regions are there, then on that time we use to blocks of ice so that that house is called igloos. Then if too much is sloping roofs is also there in mountain house, so that the snow and rains will fall down on the lands easily. Then in Kashmir, the people used house boat, so that what in house boat is boat in boat house is there. Next we can see that the nomads who can go from one place to another, they especially use the tents. So that different types of houses we have watched in this class. So I hope that you guys understood the chapter. So next chapter again I will come to teach you in the next class, but after finishing the online classes, please you go through this chapter and you can read once again. And whatever the new words and these all homework, I will upload on the website, so you can go there and you can check your homework. Thank you and have a nice day.